Good morning! Welcome to the stream, everyone. It is me, your e-daddy, Rotten Poppy, back again. Alright, I'm in comfy clothes, because we are getting ready today. You're getting dressed into the Frankie Foster's Home cosplay, so... Thank you guys for the hype train, I appreciate it. Thank you so much, Mega Man. Oh my god, Mega Man gifted a sub to Gus Webb, Westra, Buddha, and Shrugs and Drugs. Thank you so much for doing that. And also, Mindy, thank you for the bits and plugging the fan house. I appreciate that. That's another neat dude hoodie. Let's go. All right. Woo. Happy Friday, everyone. I hope that you're having a very good morning so far. I'm going to try to make sure the music isn't too loud. How's that? Claudius, thank you so much for the prime for 33 months. What the fuck, Claudius? Claudius, what? What? Holy shit. Oh, Mindy, thank you for the bits.
A prime sub. Did you know that you two can connect your Amazon Prime and Twitch accounts to get a free sub to the streamer of your choice? Be cool like that person.
Do it, guys. If you have Amazon Prime.
Since it doesn't automatically renew.
You gotta do it.
But wait, that's not all. With your Prime sub, you also receive the best emotes on Twitch, objectively, according to the inventor of Twitch.
John A. Twitch, who invented Twitch, real not fake.
Today.
I'm getting into the cosplay, Joe. That is part of it.
Be a good gifted a tier 1 sub to Sarjmo65.
Right, why is my camera over here? Hold on. There we go. Center myself. There we go. Okay, great. Pretty in Pink. Cue the Pretty in Pink movie. Thank you. I like this sweater a lot. And that's cosplay for quite a while. Is there some special story about you finding the right clothes? I just couldn't find a fucking purple skirt. That's really it. That honestly was a major pain in the ass. Like, a lot of purple skirts for some reason were like 40 bucks, which I'm like, I don't know if I'm ever gonna wear a purple skirt. So then I tried going to the thrift stores. I was having no luck for the longest fucking time until finally I found one at the Salvation Army. But I did try to buy one off of a website called Pretty Little Thing. Oh, Birgit, what the fuck, thanks so much for gifting the 5 subs. And that was less expensive, but it was like, okay, this pissed me off so bad because it did a thing where I put through the transaction and then it said, oh, there was an error, but don't worry, you weren't charged for the transaction, just try again. But I can see that I was charged for the transaction. I got the fucking email that was like, hey, you just sent money to this company. So I was like, okay, I did, but I don't know what the fuck to do. Maybe the charge will just reverse, or maybe they'll just send me the skirt anyway. I don't know. So I waited. And then they reverse the charge and then take out the charge again and then reverse it and then take it out again. And that kept on happening until finally, like, I think last week it was evened out and there's no longer a weird back and forth. I don't know. There was some fucking weird glitch. I meant to tell my bank to, like, block them, but it worked out. So, hi, Defiant. I had a brush here, and now I can't find it. Where did it go? I don't know, whatever. I'll just use a different brush, it's fine. Just a little annoying. Today I spent like fucking 10 minutes looking for my phone, and it was like right there. It happens to me like every day. Oh, I found the brush. It was right here. Damn it. What is happening to me? Oh my god. I need this. And there it is. I need to organize this drawer. Hey, when stuff like- yeah, it's so annoying. They really weren't sure whether you bought it or not. Yeah. Absolutely weird. Oh look, you can use the Pappy Ween emote. Or Daddy Ween. It's Daddy Ween. I don't know why. I don't know.
Hey, movie night is tonight, chat. Join Discord and
it's true.
Treat 2007 with us.
Thank you, Mindy. Yeah, we're watching Trick or Treat 2007. I've never seen it before. So join the Discord, assign yourself the movie night role in the role menu. And then you'll be able to be pinged when it's... Oh my god, Boots! Hi, good morning! I listened to all your messages this morning. I haven't replied yet, but I will.
Be a good gifted a tier 1 sub to its Boots.
Aw, oh, Birga, thanks so much for gifting that sub to Boots! Oh, it might be Boots with a Z. Is it completely broken? Oh, wait, maybe it disconnected. What the fuck? I have to reset it again.
Ow, 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 ow. Want more content from these two amazing humans?
Oh.
Right now, you
thank you, Mindy.
Pappy and Boots for your first month free if you sign up today.
Okay, this music is very much, very much epic. All right. True, Birgit is a real one. That's a fact. Okay, it's connecting. Alright, should be good. Should be good. Alright, alright. There it is. Oh my god, that put Boots at a year. Oh my god, look at that. What the fuck was I gonna talk about? I forgot. Oh yeah, but that's pretty much it with the cosplay. I had everything else for like a month. I did have to paint the shirt with fabric paint, but you'll see that later. Hi, Dad Survivor. I'm well, thank you, thank you. I'm excited for the weekend. I have some cleaning and stuff I gotta do. Some fall cleaning. Alright, I'm gonna pull up my reference image, I think. Hold on, this might be hard. Hold on, give me a second. It'll be faster if I do it this way. Love your hair. Oh, thank you. Cynical. Okay, let's see if I can paste the image in. Sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. Yeah. Okay. Image.
I'm so excited.
Thank you for the bits.
That I have to gift more subs for you and the Frankie cosplay also. Thanks for making week go by quick to with the Ape Escape stream, Daddy Dance.
Thank you, Mega Man. I appreciate that.
The image you tweeted makes her look like a Pokemon trainer that is about to kick my ass, and I'm cool with it.
It's kind of like she is. But not really. But kind of. Kind of like being a Pokemon trainer working for at Foster's home. Foster's home for imaginary friends. Bep, 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 bep. Is she cooler than Misty? I agree. Misty's okay. Damn, everything is like really... Alright, fuck it. We're gonna put Rainbow Road on. The music will not be epic super music today, so... Alright. Hi, Nega! It is going good today. It is going quite good. Alright. Still thinking about how you recently... You Are you saying what? Dracula? Are you? I don't know if you're talking about Castlevania or my Mavis cosplay. I actually can't tell. What are your thoughts on cheese and his love for cereal? Since when does he love cereal? I thought it was chocolate milk.
That's a Powerpuff Girls shirt she has on in that image, Daddy Pock.
Yes, she's wearing a Powerpuff Girl shirt in the whole show, actually. It's a detail I never noticed until, like, more recently. Because there's two Powerpuff Girl references in the show, because at the end, there's a Powerpuff Girl reference. You know, when they're, like, they're watching TV at the very end of the show. But yeah, didn't Cartoon Network just shut down? Isn't his whole thing chocolate milk, though? Anyway, I don't care. I don't care if he likes cereal. Yeah, it's basically... Okay, so, hold on. Let me find the exact thing. Of what happened with Cartoon Network. Cartoon Network Studios, as you know, it is gone thanks to David Zaslav. Thank you for the bits. Oh, Mom. Thank you for the bits, Mom. Warner Bros. Television Group laid off 82 scripted, unscripted, and animation employees on Tuesday and will not fill 43 more vacant positions. The 125 positions represented 26% of the company's workforce across the units. However, the layoffs were generally expected. Don't tell the whole story of what's going on in Warner Bros. Discovery animation units. In fact, there is an even more consequential announcement yesterday. Fundamentally alters the structure of Cartoon Network's studios going forward and will have far-reaching impact on the projects and that it produces. The company calls part of it a strategic realignment. Okay, so they are merging Warner Bros. Animation and Cartoon Network, and going forward, Sam Register will continue as head of Warner Bros. Animation and Cartoon Network, as well as Hanna-Barbera Studios Europe. So, apparently all three labels will exist, but perhaps more in name than in action. So, bip, bip, bip.
Hiya Pappy. Hiya chat peeps. Can't hang out long as I have high school football tonight, but hope
high school
you have
football.
An awesome.
Take care, Joseph. Thank you. What about Adult Swim? Adult Swim is owned by something else, isn't it? Because that was originally Cartoon Network, but isn't that owned by Comedy Central now?
They fired all the Sienta people, then merged it into WB and kept the CN name, so they keep pumping stuff out from CN, but it will
yes.
be written by some.
There you go. That's thank WB. You. Thank you. That's what is happening. That is a good way of explaining it. Yeah, I think Adult Swim is Okay, wait, I'm confused. It says Warner Bros. Let's look at their Wikipedia. All right, All right, so Warner Bros. Owns it, but I think it's still just its own thing. Because Warner... Wait, does Warner Bros. Own... Okay, I don't know. Fucking know. I think... Anyway. Yeah, not a part of Cartoon Network anymore. It's different people. So I don't think any of the Adult Swim staff would have been fired in that merger. I love Gravity Falls. I just watched it all a few months ago. Oh, Gravity Falls is so good. Told y'all back then how Discovery was gonna ruin things. Insert Life Finds a Way quote. I don't remember that, but maybe you did. I'm just going with Toonami. Hasn't Toonami been dead for like a decade or longer? Thank you for the bits.
Did you have a crush on Frankie too when you were younger, Pappy Davey?
I don't think so. I can't remember. Have you seen Over the Garden Wall? Yes. You can't see it. I actually have an Over the Garden Wall, poster. Oh my god, I keep clicking all the wrong stuff. Oh my god. Give me a second. Dude, that's the bottom of it right there. That's the this right there is the bottom of it. Yeah. I need to watch Over the Garden Wall. Over the Garden Wall is cool because it's, I think it's 10 minute episodes or something. So it's about movie length. You can watch it all in one sitting. Maybe Toonami is back? I don't think we have Toonami in Canada. Maybe that's why I'm confused. Wait, what the fuck? What happened to Frankie? Hold on. There we go. Never heard of Over the Garden Wall? Oh, it's so good. It's like a kid's show, but it's very Halloween. It's like a... Fuck, I'm trying to think of what to compare it to. Holy shit. It's creepy. It has a good story, but it has like cute moments as well. It's something that is very well liked among like adults. And I would say that kids that are too young probably can't watch it. Kind of like a Coraline type deal. But I would say it has freakier moments than Coraline even. I mean, depending on your personal, I guess, ideas of what's creepy. Is that a Toru Honda poster? It is. I love Fruits Basket. I think Elijah Wood plays the main character. That is, yes, that's true.
Favorite imaginary friend?
Favorite imaginary friend? When I was a kid, my favorite was Eduardo. Yeah, Eduardo's the purple one there. He always talks about how he likes potatoes. I really liked him, but I also remember really liking Will and Blue, of course. I was really into the show. I remember my sister got into it and she thought Cheese was super funny, and she got like she had a stuffed duck that she named Cheese. Cartoon Network is shutting out. Yeah, we were just talking about that. Now I remember what I was supposed to do. Download Eternal Cylinder. This is sad. Yeah, Foster Son was such a good show. Oh my gosh. Man, yeah, it's too bad about Cartoon Network. I hope that gets all fixed and figured out. But yeah, highly recommend Over the Garden Wall. It's really, really fucking good. You can watch it. It's not too long, so if you have, like, the time to watch a movie, you have the time to watch the entirety of Over the Garden Wall. It is very well written. I can't recommend it enough. The thing that got me to watch it was there's this YouTuber I used to watch. And she was talking about cartoons, And she said that she was, like, putting it on while she was going to bed. Like, she liked to put on cartoons when she was sleeping. And there's this character. Her name is, like, Auntie something. Hold on, let me look up the character name. Auntie Whispers. There's this character named Auntie Whispers. So she said that she was, like, kind of, like, dozing off. And then Auntie Whispers came on the screen and she literally, like, it, like, scared her and, like, it fucking woke her up. Because she was like, what the fuck? What? Because it's, like, really creepy. Trick or Treat with some creepy kid and boogeyman mask he stole from Night Before Christmas, is that right? I don't know. I've actually never seen it. It looks a bit like Boogeyman's mask from Nightmare Before Christmas. Missed a couple watch parties in the other Discord where I can't seem to catch the beginning. You should do it. It's good. Oh, okay, I got it. Yeah. Man, never seen it. I'm excited to check it out, though. It's very much talked about these days. Hi, Holy Ravioli. I hope you're doing good. Man. There's a fucking... Now that we talked about Foster's Home, I'm trying to think. There's, like... I feel like there's one, like, lesser scene... imaginary friend that I really liked. I'm like trying to fucking look at pictures and be like, Man, I actually don't know. I remember liking the butler, like the bunny butler guy a lot. Oh fuck. Sam is the official mascot of Trick or Treat. I don't know who Sam is. But that's very nice for Sam. Proud of Sam. Talked about that one scene. That episode has forever burnt my mind. I think it's the fucking funniest shit ever. He gets the rug burn and then he fucking messes around in the mirror for a long time with an eyebrow pencil. And they're home alone, so they do a bunch of dumb shit. They like use, what was it, like a painting to fucking slide down the stairs and then find a treasure map. It's so good. Sam's the kid with the sack mask. Ah. Nice. Yeah, don't spoil it for anyone, though, over the garden wall. Just let people find out about it and watch it on their own. Well, not find out about it, but, like, you know. Apart from the series, anyone have stories about really fucked up imaginary friends as a small child? I remember one podcaster telling listeners that their kid had an imaginary friend called Creepy Heart, which was a disattached, floating, bleeding heart. They kept drawing over and over. Jesus. No, I didn't. So I didn't know what an imaginary friend was supposed to be for a while. So I would be my imaginary friends. So I would like leave the room and come back and be like, I'm this person now. So that was weird. I don't know. That's what I did. That kid grew up to kill his dad. Well, he's never referred to as Sam in the movie. He's known as fans and the creator of Trick or Treat as Sam. Oh, interesting. Oh, My mom and grandma used to tell me about the shadow dude that kept trying to watch me play with toys as a toddler. Used to creep me the fuck out. And so you're always just walking up to your room to check on you. What? Were they pranking you, or are they saying that you had a ghost? Really, I worry about having that my kid in the house. And wake them up holding an axe or something. Some kids get really obsessed with, like, creepy shit. I have a friend who works with kids, and she said that they had to, like... What was it? Actually, I don't think they did anything about it, but they said that it was, like, a problem. That kids were getting really, really obsessed with Five Nights at Freddy's. And then, like, getting really weird. And doing, like, creepy shit. Oh my god, I was so scared of Bloody Mary as a kid, too. Some kids in my grade told me some fucking Bloody Mary stories, and it scared me for literally years. Every time I had to go to the bathroom at night, and I had to walk past the mirror, I'd be, like, thinking Bloody Mary, you know? And then I'd be, like, scared that she was gonna, like, hear my thoughts. I was very terrified of it. It was, like, a huge problem. Alright. Oh, I see. The game is just strange. It's Five Nights at Freddy's, like Chuck E. Cheese gone wrong. Yeah. Yeah, kids really like it though. Some kids are really into the spooky kinds of stuff, and yeah. Hi, Crud Muffin. The Shadow Man from Double Dragons. Wait, isn't that like bad game? I watched Double Dragon the movie in Discord last night. Have you ever seen that? No. No, I don't know what that is at all. Like Super Mario movie. Oh really? Oh shit. You wanna see that Nick Cage Totally Not Five Nights at Freddy movie? No. I bought Five Nights at Freddy's for my VR headset and it messed with me for sure. Really? Some story years back about it, some children murdering one of their classmates as some sort of offering to Slenderman. Ugh. I hope that's a fake story. Like, I'm not saying you're faking it, but like that story's not real. Because that's fucking horrible. Not fake? That's so fucked. Ugh. That makes me sad. I'm really glad that my mom didn't let me watch any scary stuff growing up. It's just, I feel like it's really hard for kids to, like, separate that in their brain, you know? My mom insisted on scary movies. Here's the trailer. I did not watch all of it, but I'm sure it's fine. Not to show it. You don't need to either. It's just a meme show. Okay, here we go.
Los Angeles. The city has changed. Cops. cops rule the day. Punks rule the night.
Wants to rule them all. The worst thing that the night could be ruled by. There's only punks. One
thing he needs to succeed.
This is only half of it. Find me the other half now.
And look who's got it.
Oh my god.
It magnifies the power inside you. This half gives power over the body.
Alright, so where's the on button?
Now, two brothers will stop at nothing to protect their half.
Look out!
This looks.
And a madman will stop.
This looks so bad, but in a fun way.
Let's have some fun.
Who wants gum?
If they succeed, they're heroes.
The fucking one-liner. Who wants gum?
He does.
Is this the kind of trailer that spoils all the good parts? Because it seems like it is.
Their history.
Watch your step.
Time to skin you guys.
Wow. Literally the entire movie's like this. Yep, this is a must-see. This is a must-see. This looks so silly. Who is that?
T2's Robert Patrick, Scott Wolf, Mark Dacascos, and Alyssa Milano. Double Dragon.
Wow.
You said it.
What the fuck?
Have to wear these, do we?
Those special effects. Yeah, it's an NES fighting game. Yeah! Okay. What is T2? Terminator? Movie is kinda based on it? Really? That's so funny. Must watch. Terminator 2? Is he the son in Terminator 2? I don't know why, but today I'm starting with the fucking the lips, I guess. He plays the cop? Oh, okay, I don't remember that. Okay. The T-3000 is a villain? Oh! I can't remember. I don't know stuff.
My hands are cold. I tried to turn the heat on. It just doesn't want to warm in here.
Sun is a slab of metal. A girder, if you will. Oh. Oh. Play Double Dragon in the arcade with my dad. When the punks kidnap your girlfriend, dad said, "Where's the thank you button?" What? Why? As soon as explosions start, Poppy goes to sleep. Yeah. Kinda. But it's better now. I watch that movie every year. Terminator 2. I remember it being good. Visiting my grandma and service out here sucks. Bye, Paul. Have a good one. Okay, this will get fixed. Hold on, I'm gonna zoom in more. Oh wait, I don't have the picture now. Where are you, Frankie? Oops. Fuck. That was the wrong thing. There we go. I heard they're making another Terminator movie? Really? Better still have Arnold. Jingle All the Way, greatest Christmas movie ever. Actually, I've grown to like that movie. It's pretty fun. I feel like I like the red squiggly dude's energy. That's Will. He plays basketball. He's pretty cool. I fucking love the N64. T2 is one of the feel-good movies of its era. I can watch it multiple times without getting bored. And personally, I've tried getting into the series after it, but they lost touch. Oh. Hi, BB! When it comes to horror games, what's some of the ones you've played? Would you stream them for the month of October? Ones I've played. I played, like, Silent Hill 2, 3, and 4. And also, what's the one for Wii called? Memories? Shattered Memories? And then I played Resident Evil 1 Remake, 2 Remake, 3, part of the 3 Remake, and then 4, and then 8. And then I played some Visage, and Dead Space, and what the fuck else? Can't remember. Did you ever play Silent Hill 2 Enhanced Edition for PC? I'm not sure. Probably that's the version I played. It's been a while. I think I'm gonna play it again next year because I think that's when it's been 5 years. Once it's been 5 years since you played something.
Well, they made like 15 Terminator movies that the main plot was look, Arnold is 734 years old and we can still make him look hot with CGI and steroids in the scene.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure which version I played, honestly. Hot in Topeka. And then in terms of what I'm gonna play this year for Scary Halloween games, I don't know. It's Cocktober, and the name of the game is the game for Cocktober is Ape Escape. So, you ever played? Wait, is it Village 8? I haven't played RE7. Yeah, Ape Escape is the official Cocktober game. Yeah, my friend needs their Ape Escape 2 game back at the end of the month. So I need to beat Ape Escape 1 and 2 before the end of the month. So that's taking priority over horror games this year. You never heard of Cocktober? Well, you're missing out because it's Cocktober.
If you don't play Ape Escape in Cocktober, I'm pretty sure a coven of witches will curse you.
It's true. It's true. I don't want to piss off the Cocktober elites. I don't usually like apes or monkeys, but you've proven these games are kind of cute and comfy. They're great. Oh, shit. Wait, so I shouldn't play my Ape Escape? Wait, are you waiting for witches to come get you? Sure, there's other ways you could piss off witches if you want to play. Celebration of roosters has nothing to do with roosters. It's Cocktober. I would say LS is a good one, but also a pain. Definitely freaky for sure, but Ape Escape is great. Yeah, there's... Hold on, I have like a couple... What the fuck games was I planning? I have a couple games. There's one game that's really weird. I can't remember the name of it. That might be a good one-off stream. Not sure. Super Monkey Ball? I don't own Super Monkey Ball, except for Super Monkey Ball Adventure, which is really fucking hard, so I haven't done anything with that. I mean, I played some of it, but then I was like, this sucks. Oh my god, Paper Mario? Yeah, Paper Mario's on the Switch retro console now. It's just about playing Silent Hill 2 at a later point. Got all links to the stuff you need to get the Enhanced Edition going. So you DM. Oh, is it like a mod? Is that what the Enhanced Edition is? Which is bursting on me not playing Ape Escape. You cocky cock! You'll pay for your crimes against humanity! Talking about Outbound Ghost? Oh shit! I see. Okay. There we go. But yeah, I need to play Silent Hill 1 first. Not first, but I still need to play that. Do you play that one yet? I played a little bit of Outbound Ghost. I think I'm gonna play more off stream. It's a little dark towards the end, like, unexpectedly, so... But not terrible. Oh, damn. Speaking of dark... This fucking music gives me flashbacks. The official HD edition of the game is a massive dumpster fire. The community got modders together and made a better HD remaster. Oh, okay. I see. I don't think the version I played was a re- It could have been. I don't remember what version I played. Honestly, I know that I played it, but it was so fucking long ago and I don't see it in my Steam library, so I have no idea. This is No. This is from, this is from Donkey Kong 64. This is the fucking, like the toy world. Where the, you have to, it's the one where you have to fight the giant Jack in the Box. It's where I got stuck before my copy of Donkey Kong 64 got stolen! Anyway, whatever. Same composer? Yeah. They're both rare. Okay. Burp burp burp. Burp 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 burp. Played Silent Hill on PS1. It was a demo. That shit freaked me out back in the day. Aw. RIP Donkey Kong. I actually got it back. A person stole it from me and then sold it to their friend, who later became my friend's boyfriend. So they gave it back to me a few years later because they told me that that person stole it from me and sold it to them. Sold it, by the way. Sold it. Got money after stealing it from me. Anyway. But also, I'm still friends with that person and they gave it back and they're the one who let me Ape Escape. So, they're pretty chill. I like them. Aw. Nega Greer. Thank you so much for the sub. I really appreciate that. They seem nice. They are nice. They are nice. When it happened, we were like, I think 13. And they were like, so essentially the person that stole it from me apparently was like, Oh, I'm pretty sure Poppy has that. She won't notice. And they were like, are you sure? I did notice. I did notice, and I was upset. Stealing the kid's shit to sell? Well, they were also a kid. So, you know, it's kid-to-kid crime. How do you know what you need to replicate a look? Do you brainstorm when looking at the picture? Like, if I want to achieve the look for the eyes here, what I have to use and how to use it? Not necessarily, because, like, you're pretty much gonna use the same eye makeup for every look. Just maybe different colors. When it comes to cartoons, there's, like, a lot of usually free room for imagination, because you're not copying an exact makeup look from a celebrity, so you can kind of take your imagination with it. This is fan art, so I like this fan art. I like the style of this fan art, so I kind of wanted to replicate the eye makeup here, but it's not necessarily going to look the same because I'm not a fucking cartoon, you know. So that's pretty much that. Yeah, I don't know how else to explain. If you have other, more specific questions, I can try to answer too. I borrowed my Donkey Kong 64 cartridge to a friend of mine who fucking lost it! I was so mad for the longest time. Nah, haha, that sucks. That's always the worst. I remember when I was, I was 17. My, friend lent me their Ocarina of Time. And I had it, I think, for like a year before I gave it back. But I gave it back. I made sure to give it back.
Wait, you're telling me you're not a cartoon? My whole life is a lie, daddy.
No, I'm a robot. But I did give it back, and then I bought the game off of a person in my town who was selling it on the marketplace. It was like before marketplace, but we had like a town Facebook group where you could sell stuff. And that was cool, but I remember how excited they were when I gave it back. They were like, oh my god, I forgot I lent you this. Thank you so much for giving it back. I would not have remembered to ask for it back. And I was like, yeah, I want to make sure you got it back. This is from GoldenEye, isn't it? Music in GoldenEye is so fucking good. It has no business being that good. You know what I mean? Love to see DK on the Nintendo Switch. Stoked they put out 007 and GoldenEye, but I hope for DK64. When is the last time that you played DK64? How long has it been? Surprised I always got the NES games I lent to my schoolmates back. I don't think they're super responsible about them. I never lost one. Wow, that's really nice. Oh god. Every time I've seen people stream GoldenEye, they've been positively surprised. Good times all around. Man, it's a good game. It really is. The controls are fucking... Ugh! My friend forced me to borrow Killer Instinct, but my older sister had to ditch a school party and it got stolen. Aww. Had to ditch school party. I see. Off topic, I saw your profile pic and you did amazing being Rona. That is so cool. Oh, thank you! I appreciate that. I have more cosplay pictures up on, Instagram and Twitter as well. You want to look at those. I'm trying to think. I lent some games to my one friend. We traded and then we got them back. The only game that I like didn't get back is one that I kind of left by accident and then didn't want it back. And that was Monkey Ball Step and Roll. I literally saved up and bought that game with fucking babysitting money. And I was so disappointed when I actually, like, played it. And I brought it to a friend's house thinking, like, okay, maybe it'll be fun with people, and it wasn't. So I forgot it when I left, and then I was like, you know what? They can just fucking have it. I don't care. Probably about 5 years ago, when I found my gold 64 out of the garage. It's only shortly after, but I miss it. Wait, but when's the last time you played Donkey Kong 64? Bought the Scott Pilgrim game a couple of days ago. It looks fun. Oh my god, that game is so fun. It's hard though. If you're struggling a lot at the beginning and dying a lot, just know that that's normal and you just keep grinding because your characters level up. First time I stream. Welcome in, Random B. I hope you're doing good. Hi, Cubby. There we go. When I came back out on Switch, I beat it in one sitting. What game? Scott Pilgrim? Oh, Scott Pilgrim. The Scott Pilgrim game. It is a good game. It really is a good game. There we go. I like seeing the Foster's Home references. It's been so long since I've watched Foster's Home. There we go. Probably Discord for this stuff, Raven. But I will say that I probably won't do the super edition the next time I play it. I might want just the old experience. But it depends on what the fuck how the fuck I play it. It's good to have as an option though. She's a Powerpuff Girls shirt. The whole time. Man, it's so cool that you can like watch so much like old stuff. I remember when I was younger, you could watch some old stuff, but I remember going on like sketchy websites that definitely gave my computer viruses in order to watch it. You know? And like some stuff was harder than others to get a hold of to try to watch. So even though now you need fucking subscription services to do it, it is nice that it's a little more accessible. God, how the fuck would this work? Yeah, maybe that. Yeah, that should be fine. Played it when I found my 64, so I played it 5 years ago. Then I binge with DK, then I followed with Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask. Ah, okay. I see what you're saying. Wonder if older shows will come back. They fired most of the Cartoon Network staff, so I don't know. I used to go on this website called Cartoon Crazy. I believe while at school. Wow. That is bold. Using 56k dial-up and a modem because I had to download music or videos was an adventure. May have not been some viruses. Oh man, no, I never experienced that. Just going on some websites. I don't remember ever using dial-up internet. I can't say for sure that it was never in my house while I was a kid, but I didn't have internet a lot of the time when I was like growing up. Should make NC, not cartoons, but really they just have an old cartoon, people making cartoons, only option. Don't forget that startup sound. For which, when was the last time you played DK? I think, how long was that, 4 years ago? 3 years ago, I 100%ed it. 50k startup. Oh, okay, right. Is that the wham or something? Sky Buddha, thank you so much for the 10 gifted subs. Oh shit. Damn. Type in chat for Sky Buddha. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Sometimes I feel like I forget how to do my makeup. Okay. Maybe it's because I just haven't washed my makeup brushes in a while, honestly. Bop, 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 bop. Oh, hi, Squid! Guys, go check out Squid Inka Dink right fucking now. See? See? Right there? Squid Inka Dink in the chat. You see their link? Go. Squid Inka Dink. Squid Inka Dink is fucking hilarious. I love you, Squid. I hope you're doing so good. Should wash mine today. I haven't washed mine in so long. I need to do that. What is wrong with me? What am I doing? Okay. That... I don't know. Maybe I'll just blend it a little more. True! Squid is a top tier streamer in person. That is a fact. Alright, I put on a nostalgic PlayStation 1 playlist. Now, it won't be nostalgic for me because I didn't have one growing up. But it should be nice sounding. The YouTuber, Squid Inka Dink, the YouTube star. Okay, maybe this one will work. Maybe this will work. Okay.
Excited for this cosplay.
Thank you very much. 13 fucking months. Oh wow, I can't believe it's been so long, Squid. I was literally thinking about that, what was it, this morning? Recently, I was like, damn, Squid and I have known each other. It's been like a year since our Waluigi Mario Party time. That was cool. I'm glad to know, Squid. My life has been better since. This is so frustrating. Okay. Honestly, eyeliner will fix all. I don't know why I'm being so weird about the eyeshadow. Like, literally, this is fine. Stumpy Monkey, thank you so much for 15 months. That was a year ago. Isn't that weird? Sorry, I keep going off screen where you can't see me. Did you reveal what the secret fun stream thing is yet? I haven't yet. I was thinking about when to do it. Ho ho ho. Oh my god. Ordo, I hope you are doing well. I forgot what we were discussing before I got distracted. Oh, Donkey Kong 64. Yeah, don't recommend fucking 100%ing that game. Although, will say, was an experience that I enjoyed sharing with the chat, of course, because it was fucked up. But that game is literally, like, broken. Like, there's some minigames that literally you need to glitch in order to beat them. So, yeah. Some parts of that game really aged really badly. A lot of backtracking, too. Been away from chat doing stuff. What the fuck? You're not allowed to do that. You are legally obligated to be here in the chat at all times, or else I will get mad at you and yell at you in front of everybody. Really good, not far from the source. Oh, thank you. Thank you, I'm trying. Okay. Okay. So now... Okay, I think I know what I'm gonna do. Okay, this is gonna be good. It's gonna be good. I need my eyeliner pen. Here it is. Have you seen the first episode of Chainsaw Man? I've heard of nothing of Chainsaw Man. I do not even know what Chainsaw Man is, so I'm the furthest thing from seeing the first episode of Chainsaw Man. What is that? Okay, I'm moving myself over here so that you can see me while I'm doing this. There's a dog. In a show called Chainsaw Man? That's not good. I don't know what happens in Chainsaw Man. But I'm afraid for the dog. Seeing pics of Garfield wielding a chainsaw on their head? Oh my god. I watched like 2 minutes before I realized Chainsaw Man is a little out of my anime depths. It's anime? First Gemini was a pain in the ass, but I had to save the awesome Ewok-looking bears. Couldn't let them be imprisoned by ants. Aw. A little weird. The weird side of anime. Yeah, that's a funny thing, is sometimes my IRL friends will be like, hey, like, I know this person, they're into anime also. And I'm like... Being someone else who watches anime could mean a million things. Like, someone could be super into anime and we could have never have watched any of the same fucking anime. Like, aside from maybe like Studio Ghibli and like Death Note. I feel like those are usually a common ground, but even then there's sometimes where someone's just like, I watch Naruto, I watch Dragon Ball Z, I watch Food Wars, and I'm like, I don't fucking know. I don't even know. Dragon Ball maybe a little bit, but discussing it is hard because I'm like, Vegeta! Saying they're into anime is kind of like saying someone's into movies. Yeah, exactly. Like, oh, they like movies. So, you know. Hard to say. This guy's super in anime. He watches it like 10 hours a day. You guys should hang out. And it's really just a horrible hentai addiction. Oh god. Thank you, Raven. No need to apologize. It's all mad made me cry, honestly. Oh boy. Yeah. Honestly, I don't know. I do like horror anime. I do. But actually, yeah, if it's a horror anime and not a horror show, then I do like that more. I don't know. I think it's just because there's a suspension of reality in a way that I really like in anime. I feel like the art style allows for some really cool concepts. Without it feeling too gruesome, you know? Hi, Ilsa Mail! Spy's Family, you would like Poppy? Maybe. What the fuck? Okay. Just carefully doing this. Carefully. Still kind of mad that they made Attack on Titan season 4 into 3 parts. Oh yeah, didn't that show like... There was like a while where people were like, you know what, don't fucking watch it. It sucks. And then they fixed it somehow. Fuck, this eyeliner is being fucking annoying. It's like I forgot how to do eyeliner.
The first 2 letters of every Harry Potter book in the series, it spells out a secret message. Ha 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 ha.
Ha! How many hours of shows do you watch a week? I don't know. You haven't seen it? I always stumbles upon, I guess, hole-in-the-wall anime. There could be more than I think, but Death Parade is a great one. I think it's only 10 episodes, and I think it's worth a watch. I think that's one I've been actually meaning to watch. I don't know. I've been... Hold on, the music is really fucking distracting me. Is it louder than it was before? Okay. The fuck was I gonna talk about? Oh, I honestly, the only show I've been watching a lot lately is Big Brother. Which, you know, is that reality show where they vote each other out of the house and they're all roommates. I love that show. It's like the only show I've really been watching for like 6 months. I don't know, guys. It's a little weird. It's a little weird. Your favorite Foster's residence? Eduardo. Coco was pretty cool too. Honestly, I remember liking them all quite a bit. I just get too cranky at shitty people that are consistently cast. Fair enough. Love the concept of Big Brother. I kind of want to be present for a board meeting when they start picking contestants over which combinations will cause the most drama. Man. I don't know. But I will say, if you haven't seen Big Brother Canada, it is actually way better than Big Brother America. The cast is always more diverse. The show, they do a lot more with the fucking, like, sets and challenges. They even have more, like, shit where the house guests do stuff together and, like, fun stuff. You know? They have, like, little challenges that they have to do, so they'll, like, tell someone, okay, like, there was a challenge where 2 people had to go and convince... 5 different housemates to give them clothes off of their body. And then if they managed to do that, the whole house got like a pizza party or something. You know, stuff like that. It's fun. Big Brother Canada is better. Hi, Mauro. I love the Big Brother Canada house more as well. Yeah, even actually on like the subreddit lately, people have been talking about how much more they like Big Brother Canada. I have that clip on your advice on starting Big Brother. Oh, really? I've lost an eye if I try to do what you're doing right now. It's definitely something that takes practice. Why is this music so epic right now? I didn't want this. I can't focus if the music is too adventurous. Ever since you told me the pizza story, I'm pretty sold on the show, TBH. Really? I said this before, but when BB started, first season of BB UK was really interesting, and no fuck-ups, no getting wasted, no advertising-related sex. Based on psychological survival, and who would- Yeah, that's- because, yeah, the other shows from different parts of the world are way different.
Literally just living with roommates. A TV show with the odd game or two thrown in.
Living with roommates, but everyone doesn't want to move out, but they gotta make each other move out of the house. I've not watched it. I mean, the pizza door thing, if anything else, is like that. It's amazing. Pizza door. Trying to think of what... of what? You're saying BB, I thought you're- Oh no, sorry! Oh yeah, cause I remember, wait. I remember. Yeah, the Big Brother in UK and- Well, I think Canada and America, the only one of the house gets- go. The house guests vote each other out, and then the other ones it's voted out by the country. So I've heard that they get more drunk and there's more like sex stuff, and it's just like people trying to be cool to the audience, which people still try to appeal to the audience in the other shows, because you know you can win money just by being the favorite. But yeah. The secret door, there's some big puzzle, and it was Subway. Oh, it was Wendy's! The Wendy's door! Oh my god, in Big Brother Canada, that was so fucking funny. Oh my god, that was so fucking funny. Yeah, because they're, Big Brother Canada has sponsorships, so they have to, like, talk about the sponsors sometimes. And there's this fucking door. This is a spoiler, but it, you know what? It's too late. Because it's just so funny. They had this door that like was counting down, and it was like it was kind of counting down at random, right? So like one day it would say 68, and then the next day it would say like 34, and it was kind of like this. So they were trying to figure out what the door was, what the secret was behind the door, and like it was like a big deal. Like everyone was even like it was, like all the watchers were trying to figure out too, like, ooh, what is this door gonna be? Is it gonna be like a secret veto? Is it gonna be, because like Big Brother Canada has like secret shit that like pops out of the walls, and there's been all kinds of like cool crazy stuff that happens. And so we were prepared for something like really wild, and they were like doing math to try to figure out like, okay, it's counting down like this, like it'll open like when there's not very many people in the house, we think. So it was like last four people in the fucking house, and it finally opens, and inside was an ad for Wendy's. It was like the fucking Ovaltine moment in a Christmas Story. And like, because it's a sponsor too, the cast, they have to be like, oh yay, it's Wendy's! Thank you, Wendy's! I mean, it was like, it was still kinda cool because it let them practice for the upcoming HOH competition, which is like one of the most important HOH competitions in the entire game. But it was like, it was so funny that like the whole point of it was really just like to plug Wendy's. It's Wendy's nuts. Got the whole country. So Trailer Park Boys was my favorite. Oh, Trailer Park Boys, yeah. Yeah. I've not seen a lot of it, but I know it. All right, here we go. Yeah, that's a great season of Big Brother. Big Brother Canada is great. Like, initially, when people were recommending it to me, I was like, I don't know. I really like the Big Brother American House, you know? But honestly, yeah, it is better. And also, it's just nice because it feels like, even though there's still the same, like, manipulation and, like, deceit and whatever that's in the show, it really just feels better because it is more diverse. And there's, like, a lot less, like, weird, you know, undertones, I feel like, you know? It's nice for that. Eleanor's always on point. Thank you, Joe Ninja. I like my boys. Tell me how to scheme and run with the boys. Just gotta make 50k and retire to the Bahamas. Nice. Be like 5 minutes. You know what? You're not allowed to take 5 minutes. That's fucked up. Just kidding. Just kidding. But yeah, as in terms of like shows, that's what I've been watching the most lately. Although I'm taking a little break right now. I just caught up with Rick and Morty. You know what? You know what? Latest season was okay. It was pretty good. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Curtis. I appreciate that. I haven't watched season... yeah, that was the same. I hadn't watched season 5 or 6. So I rewatched all of it. So I watched season 1 and 2. 3 and 4 gets, like, kind of hard to watch because it's dark. And then I felt like 5 and 6 kind of fixed that. Like, they kind of... And they kind of get meta and, like, talk about it a bit. But not really, but kind of, you know. It seems like they're trying to go back to... the older style of Rick and Morty, which is cool. I reached the IQ requirement for Rick and Morty. Oh my god. Yeah, honestly, I think that like the biggest detriment to that show was that it was its own fans. Szechuan sauce, yeah. It's me, Pickle Rick. Funniest shit I ever saw. Yeah, but I did think that season 5 and 6 are pretty good. Not gonna lie. You know? That said, do I know what flaws I need to be looking out for? You know? Do I know in your head what exactly you might have stopped watching it for? No. But if it was because of it being too dark, I feel like that was... more lighthearted, and they start kind of tying up and wrapping up some of the storylines so that they can just have some silly little fun times, which I'm happy about. Why am I okay? You know what? No, I'm not complaining. Oh my god, that's such one. Yeah, why was that a thing? It's like. You ever tried a pickle rig? It's not very good. I like pickles, but the jelly candy. What? They made a candy out of that? So the hair lights in your head. I want to say they look nice. Sending pot is- Oh, what? Thank you, Swole Tadpole. That's a nice username. Swole Tadpole. This tadpole is swole. Thank you. I appreciate the compliment. Thank you very much. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna be adding fake lashes, so this will look different.
Wings _ gifted a tier 1 sub to Swole Tadpole. They have given 821 gift subs in the channel.
I have 3 Rick and Morty shirts. Do you think that's unhealthy? No, I don't see that as being unhealthy. Since Rick and Morty was mentioned, I have to throw in this phenomenal quote. Rick and Morty, Rick and Morty, Rick, Soldier Boy. I looked up, it's basically a shot of alcohol with a chaser of pickle juice. Oh, wait, are they calling that a pickle Rick? There's a pickle rook seltzer made with pickle juice and carbonated water. I'm not saying the shot where you take alcohol and pickle juice. That I know as a pickleback. Oh, yeah, that's what you're saying. Yeah, pickleback. I like a pickleback. I thought you were saying a pickle Rick up there when you were saying, oh, I thought... I must have misread. Yeah, I like picklebacks. I made my friend try it. They were really upset. The like pickle juice that they had at the fucking place that we were was like it had like seeds and shit in it. they were like, oh yeah, we have pickle juice, and they pull out this fucking like jug, and there's just like all this shit floating in it, and I was like. You're gonna love this! The authentic pickle experience. The truest pickle. I wanna call it a pickle Rick now. Pickle back there ever was. Alright, that must have been BB. The gummy pickle Rick. It was not good. Man. The pickle juice and drinks? I'm sure I'd give it a go. I mean, it's just like, it's just a shot and then you chase it with pickle juice. So... It's good for pickle enjoyers or pickle juice enjoyers. I enjoy pickles and pickle juice. If you don't, though, then it would be not good. Okay. What is this blush? It's actually the NYX Powder Puff Lippy. They do make a blush now that comes in one of these. I don't know how good it is. I've just been using the lippies for years now, so.
I love that Rick turned himself into a pickle to get away from family therapy. I can relate, ha ha.
Time to head home. I'll be back though. Bye, West Nile. Now add it to my makeup shopping list next time. Awesome. I hope you like it. Oh, fuck, you're right. I'm sorry. Raven, thanks for gifting that sub to Swole Tadpole. I appreciate that. I saw it, and then I don't know what I was thinking or doing, but it made me not say anything right away. Okay, let's, hold on, I have to... Ah! Posture check and hydrate. Okay, I'm checking my posture, and I'm hydrating. just prefer James Francis to Picklebacks when doing easy shots? What do you mean you prefer a different shot over Pickleback? There's no way you would want something that isn't fucking pickle juice. You're lying. Nobody prefers anything over Picklebacks, okay? Once you pickle back, you never go pickle back. What do you relate with most out of the Rick and Morty family? I don't want to answer that question. I don't want to fucking talk about how awesome and relatable Rick and Morty is. I'm sorry. It's a funny show, but I'm not doing that. Can you just eat a pickle instead of including pickle juice? Well, then it's not a pickle bag. I mean, you could ask a bartender, though, if they'll give you a pickle. I'm not sure if they always have one, though. Bevy, is anybody from Rick and Morty is Mr. Poopy Butthole? You know what? You're not the first person to say that. So you know what, Mega Man, I will answer your question. I relate to Mr. Poopy Butthole the most. Typically they just have the juice, right? Yeah, I've never seen, I don't know why, like they might have it if it's a bar that has like food maybe. They might have pickles. Okay. I don't know. At this point, I don't even know what I'm doing anymore. I need to get the rest of the look together to know how the makeup is gonna look with the whole thing. Off duty! Thank you so much for gifting that sub to Shambling Undead. Shambling Undead, you are now legally required to try a pickleback without it has to be the actual juice of the pickle and not a pickle. Legally, you are bound. That's what gift subs mean in this chat. I don't make the rules, it's just how it is. What the fuck? I'm a little confused. Sky Buddha, what? Thank you so much for gifting 10 subs. What? Sky Buddha, you started a hype train? What the fuck? Thank you? Huh? Oh my god. Thank you so much. Can we get some more hype in chat for Sky Buddha? Okay, I forget how to do makeup. You know what? Balls
of steel.
Balls of steel. Happy Cocktober. Alright. It was hard. Hi Cornelius, it is hard. I hope you are doing good on this fine day of the week that it is. Friday. It's Friday. Oh my god. Thank you for the bits. I appreciate it. My mom just giving me bits. This is how it. I don't. Okay, you know what? This isn't. When do you usually do cosplay in stream? Do you get ready during the stream, or does it depend on how you're feeling? Lately I've been getting ready on stream because I think it's fun to show the process, you know? You know, there was a time for a bit where I was just getting ready before stream, but I feel like it helps. Because getting into cosplay can take longer than just my regular day-to-day makeup.
Choo-choo.
Choo-choo! Thank you very much, Raven. That's- whoa, it's a level 2, it's almost a level 3! Now that train certainly is hype. Oh, there they are. This is why I've been having problems. Wait, where's the other piece? Thank you, Off Duty, for the bits! Oh, I have a granola bar. There it is. Okay. I cut up some false lashes. And I was like, these don't look the same as they did before, but that's because... And I was missing pieces, but I found them, so we're good. I do this and this. This. I dropped it. Level 3! Okay. I got it. Okay. That wasn't it. The fuck is that? Okay. Now I got it. What is a hype train? I honestly don't know. Can you see it at the top of your chat? It's when the chat is getting hype and it makes a train. Okay. See, for some reason this music doesn't distract me. Why? How to train your hype train. Yeah, we're at a level 3 fucking hype train though. Let's go! Right. Oh, wait, hold on, I'm not behind that. Put myself back here. Oh, look at this Chili, you guys can see him. Oh, thank you for explaining that, Beer Good. I appreciate it. Did it at the top, I didn't click it. Oh, no, no, no. That's okay. I didn't even know you had to click it, honestly. Not gonna lie, I didn't even know that you had to click that. This is totally me when I don't know that you had to click that. Okay. Up, up. Lash glue on the lashes. Thanks, Shambling. Yeah, you're right. I think that's exactly it. All right. Yeah, they're glue. I was just placing them so I could see where I wanted to put them, if that makes any sense.
Alright, this one's gonna go on first. Do you guys want the playlist? Okay. Here, let me get that for you. Oh man! By the way, if you didn't hear tonight, we're watching Trick or Treat in the Discord today at 8:30 Central. So if you wanna hang out with us and join us for that, then you should join the Discord and assign yourself the Movie Night role if you haven't already. And then I'll be able to ping you and everything when it's time. It's a good time, guys. We're gonna have a great time watching Trick or Treat. Thank you guys so much for the hype train. I really appreciate it. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna stick this on now. There we go. Nice. Do you think they're gonna choose Trick or Treat? I guess it depends if they have treats or not. Is that the wrong side? That looks fucked up. That's like way too high up. Oh my god. Okay. Trying to use tweezers to be precise and then it just fucks up. I used to have a lash applicator, but I lost it. I have no clue where it went. Okay. You know what? Let's place it a little higher up here. Alright, there we go. 4:30 p.m. on my time, I'll try to stay awake. Aw, man, I'm sorry. I need to do a time zone friendly afternoon movie night one of these times. I always talk about it, and then I haven't done one yet. Thank you. Okay, lashes are on. I already styled the wig, so I just need to get it. Let me just look at more pictures. Yeah. Okay, that seems fine. Honestly, it's so in specific. I'm gonna do this a little bit. Okay. What? Oh, this. So after they did too much of the overnight shift schedule and usually end up sleeping through the start of stream or napping somewhere in the middle. Aww. That's okay. Oh, it was on. Oops, it changed. Okay. Man, yeah, why was the pause song in GoldenEye so fucking good? That was so good. So I'm putting more concealer on. I'm just telling you what I'm doing now. I'm putting more concealer on right now because I got some eyeshadow in a spot basically where I don't want it. So it helps clean up all the fucking brown and red eyeshadow that is under my eye now that I did not want there.
Aw. I'm sorry that you guys missed the streams because of night shift. Maybe someday I will stream in the night. Those random amazing songs from games were just tracks they were working on and just squeezed in to save themselves time? Possibly, hey? Okay. Okay. Okay, cool. All right. Nice. Okay, guys. I'm gonna go get into the Foster's Home Frankie outfit. And then I'll bring the wig over here. We'll put that on. So, oh wait, I gotta set my face. Hold on. I have this setting spray and I don't like it that much because for some reason it sprays out, like, flecks of orange? Not glitter. Hold on, maybe it'll do it. So, no, I don't think you can see that there's like some parts of it. So it looks like there's like bronzer or glitter or something inside of it. Oh, you can see right there. Yeah, I did it right there. Or is that a spot on my head that I don't know about? I think that was a spot on my head I didn't know about. But like it doesn't, even though I shake it, it doesn't like want to stay. Is it like orange shimmer? Yeah! That's exactly it. There's like an orange shimmer that comes out in like sometimes just whole like spots. Okay. I'll be right back. Here we go. Okay. Great cosplay. Thank you. It's not even done yet. Not even done yet. Looks great, thank you. This shirt. Okay, this shirt, I think it shrunk a little in the wash, but I used fabric paint for it. You can see it's a little splotchy at some parts. I realized that people are screen printing. You can buy printing paper that like lets you iron patterns onto shirts that you can just get off the internet. I think that's what everyone's been doing. So I painted these on. But you know what it is? What it is. Looks good. Thank you. Okay, I have to take my headphone out. Because I gotta put the wig on. So. Hold on. I need a different. So my wig is styled a little differently from the reference photo that I was using. Let me just. I'll put in the regular cartoon Frankie from the show. Oh shit, Mr. Eradication! Thank you so much!
Excited for your I got one second. Reshoot and the rest of
oh, this one's transparent. That's weird.
On your fan house LFG.
Never find a transparency when you want one and then stuff is randomly transparent. Okay. 11 months! Holy shit! Except for your cosplay reshoot and the rest of the month's content. Thank you! Thank you very much. Did you paint the power before? Yes, I did! Yes, I did. Thank you. All right, this is my favorite look that we get to do. Okay, let me just, the hairnet fucking swag. Internet chic. The cafeteria lady cosplay I've been waiting for. Lunch lady poppy. That's me. That's me. Okay, what if I... Okay. This is working a little differently than usual. Oh, there we go. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna tie this on first. Why is there not? Still not it. What the fuck? Okay, whatever. Doesn't matter. You walked by! Thank you so much for the Prime sub for 7 months! Holy shit. That's a long time, 7 months. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you very much. Mindy, for letting everyone know about the Prime.
Prime sub. Did you know that you two can connect your Amazon Prime and Twitch accounts to get a free sub to the streamer of your choice? Be cool like that person above and make sure to sub monthly since it doesn't automatically renew. But wait, that's not all. With your Prime sub, you also receive the best emotes on Twitch, objectively, according to the inventor of Twitch, John A. Twitch. Don't hesitate, sub today.
Okay. You rent or borrow the wig? No. What? Who the fuck rents and borrows wigs? Hey, this is not an angry, but be careful going into streamers' chats and announcing deaths. Some people will be affected more harshly than you may realize by a celebrity's death. And then you're putting them in a position where then they have to react to that news live. No, I bought this wig and styled and cut it myself. I did not rent it. I did not know you could rent wigs. Styling. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate that, guys. I'm glad that you like the wig. How many channel points to cut chat's hair? I don't know how to cut chat's hair. It's okay, Nick. It's not a big deal. Not everyone realizes. But yeah, it's a problem where sometimes a streamer has like an attachment to a fucking celebrity and then someone comes in and announces it and then they start crying and it's, you know. I'm just happy that Robin Williams passed away before I started streaming because for some reason I fucking cried really hard when I found out. They cut your hair? Oh, I see. I don't know if I would trust me with that. Oh, this is a man for real. For real. Man. I kind of ran out of hairspray, so I had to use gel for all of this, and I kind of wish I had some just because these bangs are going to keep wanting to fall on my face. Is he like a pop country singer? What? Pop country? Country pop. Okay, examples of country pop is Carrie Underwood, Casey Musgraves, Shania Twain, Keith Urban, Taylor Swift, Dolly Parton. I'm not seeing anyone. Maybe you mean Reb McEntire? So far, nobody has dyed hair, though. Except for Reb McEntire, who has red hair, but it's like a deep red. Never seen a Frankie Cosmo before? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Glad you like it. Thanks for the compliments on my wig. It's the mullet. It's not a mullet. She has short hair. And then part of it is tied up. I'm offended. There was this one girl I constantly see on Twitter, and it was driving me crazy because I can't find her. So three little wingdings on the t-shirt, that arrangement in that color. They're fucking Powerpuff Girls. All right, that's it. Shut up. Thanks, you're good. Reba McEntire. Reba McEntire. Okay. Nah, it's okay. It's okay. Mullets are cool sometimes. I don't know why it bothers me. This is not the look I'm going for. It's not country pop. Miss McDonald, famous country pop singer. Miss McDonald, like old McDonald had a farm. I thought wingdings was a term for that type of thing. Yeah, you know what? Powerpuff Girls are wingdings. They are my favorite wingdings. Personally, my favorite wingding, I think, is Bubbles. Best wingding around. Thanks, Dillpixel. I appreciate it. Yeah, I didn't notice until I was trying to do the cosplay that they were Powerpuff Girls. It's pretty fucking cool. The wingding girls. You have earrings? Oh, yes! Thank you for reminding me. I do have earrings. Where'd I put those? I set them down. They're right here. Thank you so much for reminding me. They're right here. Okay, so we'll see how this looks. I'm not sure. I might do... this one here. Hmm. Yeah, that works, that works, that'll work. Okay. This reminds me of it. I figured it out. It kind of reminds me of Hayley Williams. Oh yeah, I see what you're saying. Thanks, Mom. What the fuck is going on? Oh, I see what's going on. Okay, so I have this up here pierced. I don't remember what it's called. But I never put anything in it because it hurts. But today is its shining day. This will look. I might have to put a different earring here. I believe the scientific term is ear flap. I have one of my ear flaps pierced. But I never use it. Is it helix? It's called... Is it industrial? Oh, Meowry! Oh, I fucking love Jenna Lynn Meowry. Oh my god, I can't get my... What is going on? I've been wearing... Oh my god, what the fuck? No, wait, I wore earrings yesterday. Why is this being a problem? Is this, like, bent? Oh, yes, it is. This feels like the rod through the inside part. Fuck. Okay, there we go. Got it. Okay. Well, those piercings would have healed if they were used for a while, but I don't much. I still go and poke it with an earring once in a while. I just don't wear the earring. Because they will grow over, it'll get like a little skin, but also because it's pierced through cartilage, I think it's different. Kinder friends, yes. There we go. I'll never forget the first time a girl in my friend group growing up started dyeing their hair, and I asked what the meaning was behind the color change. The little boy brain didn't understand the change. Her look was drastically just because it looked cool. Oh man. Funny because some people still don't understand. Yeah, what is it called when you get the top of your earlobe pierced? Top earlobe piercing. Helix. The top ear. Yeah, so whoever said helix, you were right. It's. Nope. Wait a second. It's not where a helix should be. Hold on, give me a second. Is that, do I just have a high up helix? One second. Yeah, okay, so it is helix. Okay. Just some of them are lower down, I guess. In the example the first one showed, it was like pretty far down, so. My left ear has a little cartilage bump or something. I call it my elf ear because of it. Oh, really? Man, it's too bad that this side isn't the one that's pierced. Because this is the one that is. I don't know what this looks like. But yeah. There we go. Oh, Beaker, thank you for the bits.
I changed my hair to a split dye to reflect the changing European aristocracy at the turn of the 1700s. That and it was on sale, Kappa.
Oh my god. Okay. There we go. All right, I'm really proud of this. This turned up. Defiant, thank you so much for the Prime sub. There's like a few strands of hair that I did not cut, I guess. I'll just pull those out. There we go. I figured it out. Oh my god. Thank you very much. I really appreciate that. If you have Amazon Prime, you can do that too. Don't you know? I'm trying to like put these... Oh, thank you, Mindy.
Wahahahaha. A Prime sub.
Wahahahaha.
Did you know can connect your Amazon Prime and Twitch accounts to get a free sub to the streamer of your choice? Be cool like the person above and make sure to sub monthly since it doesn't automatically renew. But wait, that's not all. With your Prime sub, you also receive the best emotes on Twitch, objectively.
Objectively.
The inventor of Twitch, John A. Twitch.
Who invented Twitch?
Sub today.
That is real, not fake.
This was definitely spot on. You did a good job on this Stadia heap.
Thank you so much! Yeah, I'm surprised that the wig turned out as good as it did. I wasn't really sure. This will look good. Okay. Maybe? This plus a little bit more pink? Maybe? I don't know. Maybe not. Oh shit, Mr. Eradication, thank you. I'm gonna eat food soon anyway. So this is it. It's a long ass one. Can you wait? It'll play. I have to wait.
Can you do your best Frankie from Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends impression? This cosplay is definitely my top 5 cosplays you have done.
Oh, thank you. Shit, I don't know. What's like a thing that she says?
You. You're nice trying to your
who you guys hold on
with a that's what I like your buddy. I thought you were you know powdering your nose.
I powdered it before I left.
She's so cute when she's mad.
So it's not what it looks like. It's
if I had a dime for every time I heard that one.
No really.
I don't know
who
if I can do it.
Stole my whiskey bottle. If CPS finds out about this again, I'm going to lose my foster home license, Frankie. A very real quote.
I fucking pulling up. Quotes. I accidentally opened up fan fiction just then. That was written as quotes. Okay. Hey, Blue! Welcome to Foster's home! I hope you like it here.
That's my impression for you.
Ah, homie.
It's a good impression. Practice while you're heating up your lunch.
Hello! Hi!
Ah, I'm proud of this. I can't believe how it turned out. Yay! Yay!